welcome back to online classes for maths. Okay, and yesterday I have taught you the new chapter number 3, factors and multiples, and I have taught you about this, and I have even started the new exercise 3.1, and I have taught you till question number 5. I hope you have done in your copy these questions and the homeworks which I have given you, and I hope you have no doubts. And if you have any doubt, I always say you can clear your doubt. You can message me whatever doubts you have, I'll clear your doubts. Okay. So yesterday we have done till question number 5. So today we'll start question number 6. Okay, so let us start. Okay. So question number 6 is find all the factors of the following numbers. So here in this question, few numbers were given. I have just chose one number, okay, to make you understand whatever I'll teach you how to do. You will apply the same thing in the other numbers also. So I have chosen only one number to show you. So what is the question is asking is that we have to write all the factors of 42. That means 42 comes in which we table. Okay, so here we are going to write that in which we table this 42 comes. So we'll start from 1 because 1 is the factor of every number. So 1 is the factor. Okay, so 1 into what we will multiply? 1 into 42 we will do. So what you will get? 42. That means 1 is also the factor and 42 is also the factor. This both is a factor of 42. That means 1 is also factor and 42 is also factor. So you can do both the side, okay, to the end and from the starting. It will become very easy for you. So 1, 42, just 42. That means 42 is also the factor. So I will write here 42. This is the end. That means the number itself is a factor. Now will this come in the 2 table? Yes, it will come because you can see here what is it? Even number is it. That means it will come in 2 tables. Now 2 is also the factor. Okay. So 2, how much are 42? 2, 21 are 42. That means you see, I am making it easy for you to do. That means 2 is also the factor and 21 is also the factor. Yesterday I have taught you this, that this multiplicate and the multiplier both are the factors. That means 21 and that means 2 and 21 both are the factors. So 2 I have written here, 21 I will write there. Okay, 21 I will write there. We are doing both the side. Okay, that means between this 21 to 42 there are no factors. 21 and 42 is the factor. Now let us find more factors. Now next is with the table of 3. So will this come in the table of 3? So what you have to do for that? We will add 4 plus 2 is how much? It is 6. So 6 comes in 3 table. Yes. That means 42 will come in 3 table. Okay, so 3 is the factor. So 3, how much is 42? Okay, so 3, 14 that you will do, you will get 42. Okay, that means 3 is the factor we have written. That means 14 is also the factor. So here we can write 14. Okay, now next one is that will this come in the 5 table? No, because 5 or 0 should be there in the 1's place, not there. Will it come in the 6 table? Yes, you know that the 6, 7 is the. Okay, you know 6, 7 is 42. That means 6 is also the factor and 7 is also the factor of 42. So here we can write 6 and 7. Now see here why it has become easy. Now there are no factors. Now there are no factors. We have already got easily, we have done this. Otherwise you can write it comes in 1 table, 2 table, like that you can do. Okay, otherwise if you will do this one, if you write this way, it will become very easy. See, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 14, 21, 42 is the factor. Now no other number is there in which this 42 comes. Okay, so you have seen it becomes very easy for to do the factors. If you write this way, this both side becomes the factor and easily you can do it. Okay, so this was about the factors. Now let us see what is question number 7. Question number 7 is, write the prime factorization of the following. Now here also I chose one number, that is question number 10, 5400. So here we are going to do the prime factorization. Okay. So that also I have already taught you. So let us do it once again. It will become for us more good practice will be there for us. Okay. So let us do this prime factorization. So how to do this prime factorization? I have already taught you. What we have to do is that you have to do this prime factorization with prime numbers only. Okay. It should be with prime numbers. So prime numbers starts from 2. So we will check for 2. Then if it doesn't come, then 3, we will move on. So let us check for 2 whether it comes or not. You can see at the 1's place 0 is there. That means it will come in the 2 table. Okay. So 2, 2 is a 4. 1 given to it, it is 5. So it becomes 14. So 2, 7 is a 14, 0, 0. Again it will go with the 2 table because 0 is there. 2, 1 is a 2. 2, 3 is a 6. Again 1, that means it becomes 10. So 2, 5 again by 2, 2 6 is 12, 1 given 2 it becomes 15. Okay, so 2 7 is 14, 1 given 2 it becomes 10, so 2 5 is 10. Now this will not come in 2 table. Okay, it will not come in 2 table because 5 is there at the 1's place. So now let us check for the 3. 3 is a prime number. So how to check? You know that where, what you have to do? You have to add. 6 plus 7 is how much? It is 13. Okay, 6 plus 7 is 13. 13 plus 5 is how much? Is 18. How much it is? 18. So 18 comes in 3 table. Yes, that means this 675 will come in 3 table. It is divisible by 3. Okay, so now let us do this. 3 to the 6, 3 to the 6, 7 was there, given 2 it becomes 15, so 3 5 is 15. Now let us again check for 3 table. So 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 5 is how much? Is 9. So 9 comes in the 3 table. Okay, so this is also divisible by 3. So 3 7 is 21, 1 given 2 it becomes 15, so 3 5 is 15. Okay, now again we will do, okay, 7 plus 5 is 12, it will again come in the 3 table. That means 3 to the 6, 1 given it becomes 15, so 3 5 is 15. Now this 25 will not come in 3 table, it will come directly in the 5 table. So 5 5 is 25, 5 and 5. Okay, so done. We have done this. Now we will write the prime factorization. Okay, now we will write the prime factorization. Okay, so prime factorization of 5400 is, so what it is, how many 2 is there? 3 2 is there, 2 into 2 into 2 into how many 3 is there? 3 3 is there, 3 into 3 into 3, how many 5 is there? 2 5 is there, that means 5 into 5. Okay, so this is the prime factorization of 5400. When you multiply this, you will get 5400. Okay, now let us do question number, we have done till question number 7, now we will do question number 8. Okay, now question number 8 is the last question of this exercise. With this, we will complete this exercise and we will move to the new exercise 3.2. Okay, so now let us see what is this. Question number 8, express the prime factorization as a product of prime factors in exponential form. Okay, so this also I have taught you. Okay, so let us do it again. I have chosen only one question, that is 3, and the number given is what? 900. So here we are going to find the prime factorization we are going to do, okay, and we are going to find the answer, okay, in exponential form. Okay, so let us start. 900. So you know that you start with the prime numbers. Just now we have done the prime factorization, so it will go with the table of 2. 0 is there, so 2 4 is 8, 1 given it becomes 10, 2 5 is 10, 0. 2 to the 4, 2 to the 4, 1 given 2 it becomes 10, so 2 5 is 10. Okay, now will this go with the table of 3, because it will not go with the table of 2 because 5 is there. So for 3, we will add 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 plus 5 is 9. Yes, it will go. Okay, so 3, 7 is 21, 1 given 2 becomes 15, so 3, 5 is 15. Again, we will add 7 plus 5 is 12, it will go with the table of 3 again. So 3 to the 6, 1 given 2 becomes 15, so 3, 5 is 15. Again, it is now 25, 25 doesn't come in 3 table, so what we will write? Directly comes in 5 table. So 5 is 25, 5 and 5. Okay, so we got. So first, what we will do is that we will write prime factorization. Okay, prime factorization of 900. So what it is? How many 2 is there? 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. Okay, we have done this. Now we will do in exponential form. They are asking the prime factors in the exponential. These are what? These are the prime factors. Okay. These we have done prime factorization. Okay. And these are the prime factors we use because these are what? Prime numbers. So these are prime factors. So now we have. So now we have to do in the what? Exponential form. Okay. So how to do is that we have to find the product. I want to say we have to find prime factorization as a product of prime factors. Okay. So how to do is that in. We will write it in exponential form. So you can see here what is it? 2. So 2 is the what? Base. Okay, we will write here 2. Okay, those are not understood yesterday. You can see here again how to do in the exponential form. Here 2 is there, that means we will write here 2. 2 is the base. And how many 2 is there? 1, 2. How many is there? 2, 2 divided into, now what is there? 5. How many 5 is there? 2, 5. That means you will write 2. So these are what? Base. 2 is the base, 3 is the base, 5 is the base. But these are what? Exponent. These are the powers. Okay? So if it will be given in the power form, how to expand and multiply? 2 is the base and whatever the power will be given, 4, 5, 6, whatever it is given, so base will multiply that much. 2 into 2 into 2 into like that you have to do. 3 into 3 into 3, not 3 to ja or what is it, 5 to ja, not like that. 5 to the power 2 means 5 you will multiply 2 times. 5 into. Okay, so with this we have completed our exercise 3.1. Now let us move to exercise 3.2. Okay, now let us start the new exercise, that is 3.2. Okay, so in this exercise you will learn how to do SCF, how to do LCM, and the question based on this SCF and LCM. Okay, so today I'll take a few questions of this exercise, then whatever left will be there, left ones I'll continue in my next class. Okay, so let us start with the first question, that is find the SCF of the following numbers. So here also few questions were given. I chose one question to show you how to do. So if you have any doubt in other questions, you can ask me. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can message me. Again, I'm saying you to clear your doubt. So let us start to do this SCF. So SCF means what? Highest common factor. Okay, so SCF means that highest common factor. So here we are going to find the highest common factor. And you can use any method, by prime factorization method, by what is a long division method, or by common division method. Here I will do prime factorization method, as we have already done this. You can use any method, as method is not written, you will do by any method, your method is correct. Okay, if you will do it correctly, that means it is correct. You can use any method to find. So here I am going to do the prime factorization method. So let us start. You will write 108, because already we have done prime factorization method, so we will do that. Okay, so now how to do, you already know, you go with the table of 2, as 8 is there, so 2 5 is a 10, 4 is a 8, 2 2 is a 4, 2 7 is a 14. Now 27 will not come in 2 table, it will come in 3 table. 3 9 is 27, 3 3 is a 9, 3 1 is a 3, 10. Now let us do the prime factorization of this 162. So what it is? It will go with the table of 2. So 2 8 is 16, 2 and 2. Now it will not go with the table of 2. Will it go with the table of 3? So 8 plus 1 is what? 9. So 9 comes in the 3 table. So 3 to the 6. 2 given, so it becomes 21. So 3, 7 to 21. Now see, now it is same. You can copy from here or you can do it like this. 3, 9 to 27. 9, 3, 9, 3. Okay, now what we will write? We will write here prime factors of 108. Okay, then we will write here prime factors of 162. So what are the prime factors of this 108? How many 2 is there? 2. 2 into 2. How many 3 is there? 3. How many 2 is there? Only 1. How many 3 is there? 4. Okay. Now what we have to do next is that we have to find the common. Okay. So 2 is common. Now no more 2 is common. 3 is common. 3 is common. 3 is common. Okay. Now what are the common factors? We will find the product of that. Okay, so product of common prime factors. So what is the product? What is the common? 2. Out of this will write 1, 3. 1, 3. 1, 3. Okay, so what is the answer? 2, 3 is 6. 6, 3 is 18. 18, 3 is a, how much? 54. We got 54. And what is the 54? 54 is the SCF. It is the highest common factor. This is the highest common factor in which both this number comes, 108 and 162. So what is the SCF? SCF of 108 and 162 is 54. So this is the answer. is the highest common factor, that is 54 is the answer. Okay, so in this same way you can do the other questions of this essay. I said you can use any method to solve this, okay, either by long division method, either by common division method, or if you want you can do by prime factorization method. Okay, so now let us do what is question number. Now let us do question number 2. What is question number 2? Find the LCM of the following numbers. So in this question we are going to do LCM. You already know how to do LCM. LCM, what does LCM means? Least common multiple. Okay, so in this question we are going to find the least common multiple. Okay, so here the numbers are given. So now we are going to find the LCM. So let us start. This is 390, 260, okay, and 580. So now let us start. Okay, if any one number doesn't come in two table, so we will start there. Okay, so this will come in two table because 0 0 is there, so 2 and the 2, 1 2 and 2 8 becomes 19. So 2 9 is 18, 1 2 and becomes 10, so 2 5 is 10, 1 is 2, 2 is 6, 0. This doesn't come in two table, so we will copy the same. Okay, now if this will go in the two table, so we will copy the same, it will not go. So 2 6 are 12, 1 2 becomes 10, so 2 5 is 10, 5 8 5. Okay, now let us check for 3 table whether it comes in 3 table or not. Okay, so 1 plus 9 is 10, 10 plus 5 is what? 15, it will come in 3 table. 6 plus 5 is 11, it will not come, this will come. 5 plus 8 is how much? It is 13, 13 plus 5 is 18, that means this and this will come in 3 table, this will not come, so we will copy that same. So 3 6 are 18, 1 given to it becomes 15. 3 5 is 15, 6 is 5, you copy it. 3 1 is 3, 2 given to it becomes 28, so 3 9 is 27, 1 given to it becomes 15, so 3 5 is 15. Okay, now this will not come, this will also not come in 3 table, this will come. 9 plus 1 is what? It is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15, it will come, so we will copy this same. Okay, now 3 6 is 18, 3 5 is 15. Now all are 65, 65, 65. So this will now come directly in the 5 table. Okay, so 5 and the 5, 5 and the 15. 5 same, see it is same, so we can do. Now this is a prime number. 13 is a prime number, it comes in its own table. So we can write here 13 1 jar, 13 1 jar, 13 1 jar. Okay, now what we have to do? We have to find the LCM. So we can write here LCM of what? 390, 260, 585 is. So what it is, what we have to do is that we have to find the product of this. Okay, you can write this down. First we find the product. Okay. So then that will become the LCM. I have already written here, so you can write it, copy it. What to say first. Okay, so 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12, 12 is the how much? 36. Okay, so up to here you can write 36 into 5 into 30. Okay, so 36 into, you know that 5, 30 is the how much? It is 65. So I will write here 60. Now we will multiply this. Okay, so 36 into 65, how much is there? Let us multiply. 5 is a 33, carry 5 is a 15 plus 3 is 18. 6 is a 36, 3 carry 6 is a 18 plus 3 is how much is 21. Now add it 0. 8 plus 6 is 14. 1 given to it becomes 3, so 2. So what is the answer? Is 2340. Okay, this is the product. We have multiplied this, okay, and we got 2340. So what is the LCM? LCM of 390, 260, 585 is how much? It is 2340, and this is the answer. Okay, so in this way you can find the LCM. So for today up to this much. Okay, in my next class I'll complete this chapter. Okay, then again we will move to the new chapter. Okay, so for today up to this much, your work is that you will do this in your copy as a classwork, as I teach you, you will do this, okay, together. So that will be your good practice, and it will be your classwork also, and some questions I'll give you will become your homework. Okay, so when you see the video, you do it together, it will be very good for you. And if you have any doubt, then ask me, you can clear your doubts. Okay, so for today up to